Everybody, thanks for logging on for your forecast. Still watching for the possibility of strong to severe storms later today as the wind starts to pick up a little bit. Woodruff Road Skycam shaking just a little bit in the wind outside. We've seen mostly cloudy skies for much of the morning, but if the sunshine starts to come out like it possibly will over the next couple of hours and temperatures really start to warm up, that could amp up our severe weather threat a little bit heading into this afternoon. At least for the moment, a lot of those storms have stayed down to the south and east. We've mostly just seen scattered showers across the board. We had a wake low overnight last night, and that kind of disrupted the morning round of possible thunderstorms. It's mostly just been rain that we've been seeing out there stretched across western North Carolina for now, letting up a little bit in the upstate, but we're really watching the visible satellite picture for any clearing skies, because as soon as the temperature possibly start warming up, we could possibly have some strong to severe storms develop this afternoon. Live Super Doppler 4, some of those downpours have gotten a little bit heavier across Transylvania County, northern Oconee counties, but at least for much of the day today, it's been pretty dry farther south towards places like Abbeville and Greenwood. I don't want you to let your guard down, though. We've got some more high-res future radar data indicating that some of these storms that do develop this afternoon, they may have some embedded rotation. You see the clearing skies here. That is really going to help to warm temperatures up and give the storms what they need to really initiate. And then if they do start to initiate, they could be working with a pretty favorable environment for possibly severe weather or even tornadoes. I put the rotation tracks over top of the future radar so you can get a better look at it. These little cells here, if they do start popping up, we're really going to have to watch them very closely. You see here, some of these have some rotation possibly embedded within them, and that's mainly going to be from the middle part of the afternoon into the early evening, a narrow window where we have some possible strong to severe storms. Check out this freeze frame right here. The exact location of the cell, it may vary a little bit, but this just goes to show you anything that does pop up could have some moderate to strong rotation in it. And then once we get past 6 o'clock, a lot of these downpours that come in later in the evening, they probably will not be severe because they'll be on the backside of the storm system closer to the cold front. Just for now, make sure that you have your guard up just in case. Make sure you have a severe weather plan ready to go in the event of a tornado warning. Other than that, the wind gusts are just going to be the main thing for all of us as the gusts pick up to 30 to 35 miles per hour this afternoon, relax somewhat into tomorrow morning, and then pick back up as the front comes in, or as the colder, drier comes in back behind the storm system heading into tomorrow. Still looking at possibly 35 to 40 mile per hour gusts heading into tomorrow. So here's what I've got for the 4-day isolated, possibly strong to severe storms the rest of the day, or the rest of the afternoon, I should say, today, as temperatures top out in the upper 70s. A little cooler tomorrow with highs in the upper 60s, drying out with mostly just high winds. Saturday, we're calmer and warming back up with highs in the mid 70s. Still looking warmer for Sunday as well with highs in the low 80s, and we keep with warmer and drier conditions Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, with highs getting up into the mid-80s for the early part of next week. Stays a little bit windier for longer in western North Carolina, as well as cooler, low 60s for highs tomorrow, upper 60s for Saturday, and then finally starting to warm back up on Sunday with highs in the upper 70s and low 80s for early next week. Make sure you keep it tuned on WYFF4 in the event of those severe storms moving through your area.